Oh, this is the ugliest structure I've seen. Hey everyone, what's up? I'm out here in the middle of a gentle rain, just trying to demonstrate a little bit of what's going on with this rain shed that I built. I'll just give you a quick tour around it, and you can see how the rain is coming on the roof, coming down through the gutters and getting into the storage system. You've got obviously the rain with a simple guttering system on it, and see the water in there. I need to clean out my gutters, but they're pretty easy to clean because it's right here at hand level. And that is guttering down here into basically just a little flex attachment here that I stuck on here, and that goes inside the rain shed, and I'll show you where it picks up inside. So I just have this kind of tarp in front of this, and inside there's actually three IBC totes in here, three of these pretty large containers. This first one here is actually a worm bin. I'll do another video about that at some point, but next to it, come here in the center, we've got two additional totes. And those two totes are actually, you can see in the bottom, they're plumbed together. The taps on both of them are open, and they both fill and drain at the same time. You can see in the system right now, you can see right here, there's a line here for how much water is in the system. See the same line over here. So that line over here is at 150. So there's probably about 300 gallons right now in this system. And the whole thing, once it's plumbed together, I just use these little fern coat tees. And this, I believe, is I don't remember what this is. I think it's a 2-inch clean out that attached onto the end of this tap, and then that allowed me to put these Fernco fittings on it and just put a little two inch piece of PVC here, and then it comes over here to this little hose pipe fitting. There's a little brass fitting here, and I can turn it on. It's just a quarter turn. Turn it off, and that runs its way out to the garden. But you can see in the top of this system, this one has the cover on, not all the way, just to allow the air pressure to escape. But over here, it gets a little dark and noisy in here. You can see I've got just some bricks on here, and you can see the water kind of trickling in slowly. There's a simple screen on here, and then I bent some chicken wire around it to kind of form it down, and then put some bricks on there just to hold it all in place. And you can kind of see how all that fits through the tarp. The tarp is honestly on here just to keep the light kind of cut down in here so that the bins don't grow a bunch of algae. I do have high intentions of actually finishing this thing out with some more permanent walls, but right now the tarp kind of functions as that layer that keeps everything from getting, well, it keeps the worms from being bothered by light, because the worms really don't like light. They really like it to be pretty dark. But it also keeps the algae out of the rain system. So this was just kind of an experiment, because for us, our garden, you can kind of see the house right there. It's pretty far away from where our garden is, and you can kind of see here's the garden being watered right now. And there's no water out here at this part of the property. It's kind of far away. So in years past, if we needed to water anything, it was in a 5-gallon bucket that me or my wife or one of our children was hauling out here. It was pretty miserable. So this whole rain shed idea it's a way of getting water out to the garden, but also is honestly just a way of saying, I'd really like to be a little more self-sufficient with water, because we do have a stream on the property, but it's way down at the bottom of a very long hill. It would be a serious hoof to get it up here. So this just puts water higher in the landscape, which is really important for being able to use gravity to move water around your property. Water low on the property is not worth a whole lot. Water high on the property is worth an extreme amount. So this is, you can't probably tell, but our garden is actually sloped. That goes downhill. And so this rain shed is up here at the top of the hill. And that allows us to gravity feed everything down. And I will say, I've tried the system with about 300 gallons in it. There's not a lot of water pressure coming off the system. You would expect it, but I'm not sure why. I'd love to look into that, or maybe you can tell me in the comments some ideas about why you think there might not be a lot of water pressure coming out of here. It just kind of runs out at a small trickle out of the hose. And I've checked the fittings and checked everything, made sure there's no clogs in the line. It's not that. It's just the water isn't being forced out very, very heavily. So not sure why that is. So that's just the simple rain shed. I'll kind of back up and give you a fuller picture of the whole deal. So this is the shed as it stands. I'd like to finish in this area here with additional pallets, just to kind of, you know, make the thing look a little more sensible and solid. And then also just maybe stain the outside of it just for a little bit of, since this is right here on the road where cars drive by, we tend to be a little bit more particular about making things look a little better when it's close to the road, because you want farming to be attractive to people. You don't want it to be an eyesore. You don't want to put stuff up on your property that just makes everybody mad at you for wrecking their property values. So trying to do this stuff cheaply, but make it look decent. And this is just a pallet shed. Honestly, I think I just bought a couple of 4x4 posts for the corners, and then just screwed a bunch of pallets together, and they're sitting on old concrete cinder blocks. It's not a complicated system. The roof, just for giggles, honestly, I did some sort of kind of basic timber framing stuff. That was just more of a personal thing. I just wanted to fool around with it. So I notched out all the boards and things in here. Notched them out here. But I mean, that was just me fooling around. So I was just trying things, and that's what everybody should do, man. You should try stuff. You never know what's gonna happen. Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button down below, subscribe to the channel. That helps me make more videos just like this one. And remember, whatever you're doing on the homestead, whatever you're doing on your farm, just try something. Just try something.